Hello everybody, welcome to my channel Knowledge Hub, just grab it. In today's lecture we will be discussing on sales day book, which is a part of subsidiary book. So similar like purchase day book, we will be discussing some key points to understand which transactions will be posted or recorded in the sales day book. So what are those important points we need to remember? First, sales day book records all the transaction of credit sale of goods to customer. What does it mean? If I repeat the statement again, sales day book records all the transaction of credit sale of goods to customer. Here I have pointed out or highlighted two important word, credit sale and sale of goods. So what does it mean? It means that whenever you are selling something to a customer, and if it is on credit, matlab aapne koi customer ko kuch becha and वो क्रेडिट में बेचा, देन इट विल बी रिकॉर्डेड इन द सेल्स डे बुक. एंड ऑल्सो जो चीज आप बेच रहे हो, दैट इज दैट शुड बी गुड्स. मतलब आप अगर कोई फर्नीचर बिजनेस कर रहे हो, देन इट हैज टू बी द गुड्स ऑन व्हिच यू आर डूइंग बिजनेस. आप फर्नीचर बिजनेस कर रहे हो तो जो चीज आप क्रेडिट में बेच रहे हो, दैट हैज टू बी द बिजनेस रिलेटेड थिंग्स. लाइक इन केस ऑफ फर्नीचर बिजनेस, इट शुड बी फर्नीचर रिलेटेड थिंग्स. सेकेंड पॉइंट, सेल ऑफ अदर थिंग्स देन गुड्स लाइक एसेट शैल नॉट बी रिकॉर्डेड इन द सेल्स डे बुक. व्हाट डज इट मीन? जो मैंने पहले भी बोला यही कि जो चीज आप बेच रहे हो, दैट शुड बी रिलेटेड टू योर बिजनेस. मतलब जो चीज के ऊपर आप बिजनेस कर रहे हो, अगर आप एक कंप्यूटर बेच रहे हो एक फर्नीचर कंपनी होके, दैट विल बी सेलिंग ऑफ द एसेट. अगर आप मशीनरी बेच रहे हो, प्लांट बेच रहे हो, दैट विल बी सेलिंग ऑफ द एसेट, बट इट कैन नॉट बी पोस्टेड और रिकॉर्डेड इन द सेल्स डे बुक. Also, point number 3, if goods are sold in cash, like आप अगर कुछ चीज बेच रहे हो and hard cash में बेच रहे हो, then and there you are getting the hard money, then it will not be posted in the sales day book. Now, the format of the sales day book. Format of the sales day book, similar like purchase day book. यहाँ पर तीन चार कॉलम होते हैं. लाइक फर्स्ट इज द डेट, देन पर्टिकुलर वेयर यू हैव टू मेंशन हु इज द कस्टमर एंड व्हाट प्रोडक्ट यू आर सेलिंग, देन इनवॉइस रेफरेंस नंबर, लेजर फोलियो, अमाउंट एंड रिमार्क्स. नाउ वी विल अंडरस्टैंड द सेल्स डे बुक यूजिंग एन एग्जाम्पल. लेट अस सी हाउ विल बी द फॉलोइंग ट्रांजेक्शंस रिकॉर्डेड इन द बुक्स ऑफ ए क्लॉथ मर्चेंट. सो फर्स्ट, what is the first transaction? 1st July sold tip top clothing 50 suits of rupees 2200 each on 2 months credit on invoice number 2. Second transaction is on 11th of July sold to New India Woolen 100 sweaters at rupees 250 each on invoice number 55. 13th July received an order from Modern Clothing for 100 trousers at rupees 500 at a trade discount of 10%. On 7th July sold 50 saris to Lunkud Brothers at 750 each, and 25th July sold t-shirts at exhibition hall for cash for 7500. Now we will go one by one and see whether this transaction will be posted in sales day book or not. So first transaction, sold clothing of 50 suits rupees 1200 each on 2 months credit. So you are a cloth merchant, you are selling 50 suits on credit. So you are selling the goods on which you are doing business and you are selling on credit. So it will be posted in the sales day book. So date sold close to tip top clothing, sold goods is suits, invoice number 2 and amount 2200 into 50, total 110,000 rupees. Next transaction, 11th of July, sold to New India Woolen 100 sweaters at rupees 250 each on invoice number 55. So first criteria, that it is a goods on which you are doing business. But the second criteria is missing in the statement. Nowhere it is mentioned that whether this has been sold on credit or using cash. So as there is nothing is mentioned, we would assume that it has been sold on credit. So second transaction, sold to New India Woolen, sold sweater, invoice number 55. So 250 rupees into 100 sweaters, so 25,000. Now third statement, 13th July, received an order from Modern Clothing for 100 trousers at 500 at a trade discount of 10%. Now here nowhere it is mentioned this has been sold. Here it is mentioned that we have received the order only. We have received the order only. It may be that this in the order from Modern Clothing, it has been mentioned that payment terms is using credit. Matlab hab 100 trouser bechoge credit pe, matlab 30 din baad ya fir 60 din baad aapko paisa milega. Par yahan par aap logo ne invoice nahi kiya hai. You have just taken the order. So that is why it will not be posted in the sales day book. Whenever you are posting something in the sales day book, that means sales has happened, invoice has generated. But here you have only received the order. No sales has been happened, no invoice has been generated. So that is why this in this particular transaction, it will not be posted in the sales day book. Now 17th July, sold 50 sharis to Lunkat Brothers at 750 each. So we are selling sarees on which we are doing business. That means the sold thing is goods. And here nothing is mentioned regarding the medium of the sale, that is whether credit or cash sale. So as nothing is mentioned, we would assume that it is a credit sale. So in this particular statement, the transaction will be posted in the sales day book. So we have posted the transaction, sold to Lunkat Brothers, sold sarees, and it is 750 into 50. Now the last statement, 25th of July, sold t-shirts at exhibition hall for cash for rupees 7500. Here we are selling t-shirts on which we are doing business, that is it is good. But the problem is here, we are selling it using cash. So it will not be posted in the sales day book. It will be posted in the cash book. So this particular two statement or two transaction where it is mentioned that first one is order only we have received the order. So that is why it will not be posted in the sales day book. And the last one here, the sales has happened by hard cash, it is not using the credit, so that is why it will not be posted in the sales day book. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you understand the basic concept of sales day book and how the transaction is posted in the sales day book. If you like my video and if I am being able to make you understand, I request you to subscribe my channel, like, comment. If any doubt, please comment. I will reply that one. Thank you.